Hello everyone, today we'll deal with section 5 and section 6 of the Specific Relief Act that deals with recovery of the possession of specific immovable property. So when it comes to the immovable property, we will get the immovable property in the two ways, that is we can prove the ownership title or we can prove the possessory title. So if you want to prove that you are the owner of the property, then give the evidence, give the title deeds, then the court will consider the title deeds and will grant you ownership of the property. And when it comes to possessory title, then if you are in possession of the immovable property, then no one can dispossess you otherwise than in due course of law or by using force to eject you. So basically the ejectment and recovery can all be attained through civil procedure code or by filing a suit in the court of law. Now let's see section 5. It says a person entitled to the possession of specific immovable property may recover it in the manner provided by the civil procedure code 1908. So under section 5, one who proves the better title to the property, he can get the benefit of the possession of the property under section 5. So also this section mentions the procedure laid down in CPC 1900. So what is that? If suppose a suit is filed under section 5, then a decree is passed, then the decree will be then executed as per in order 21, rule 35 and 36 of the civil procedure code. Then the possession will be given to the person entitled. And what is the limitation period? Suit must be filed within 12 years from the date of disposition in a civil court. It is given under Article 64, 65 of the Limitation Act. So this is all about Section 5. Now let's see Section 6. So first of all, let's see the requirements of Section 6. Section 6 deals with suit by person dispossessed of the immovable property. Section 5 was talking about the title. Now Section 6 talks about possession. Only the suit can be filed when a person is dispossessed of the immovable property. So now let's see the ingredients. The person suing was in possession of the immovable property. Then he must have been dispossessed of the immovable property. Such disposition must be in otherwise due course of law. That means he must not have been dispossessed in due course of law. That means he must have been dispossessed by using force or by throwing someone, so, or cutting the electricity. Likewise, then the suit must be brought within 6 months from the date of disposition. So here the limitation period mentioned is 6 months from the date of disposition. Also, no suit can be brought against the government. There is no appeal or review of any such order or decree passed by the court. It is basically a summary remedy, but here revision lies on the mere error of law. Here the position talked about must be peaceful or settled or juridical position. Example, he must be in possession through method of lease or mortgage, etc. So now let's see who may file a suit under this section. So after the 2018 amendment, another person category has been added here. So now there are three categories. First is the person who is dispossessed himself may file the suit. Secondly, any person claiming through him. Thirdly, which has been added through the 2018 amendment, that is through whom he has been in possession of the immovable property. So these three categories can file the suit. So now section 6 clause 4, it says nothing in this section shall bar any person from suing to establish his title to such property and to recover the possession thereof. That means if a person has filed a suit for recovery of the possession, that means he has been dispossessed otherwise than in due course of law, then he is filing the suit within 6 months from the date of disposition, then also he can file another suit on the basis of title under section 5 of the Specific Relief Act. And the order granted under section 6 will not be considered as a res judicata or a bar in the suit filed further under section 5. So now let's see the difference between section 5 and section 6 of the specific relief act. Under section 5, one who has the better title to the property, he will get the benefit of the possession of the property. That means only title is to be proved under section 5. But in section 6, only the possession is to be seen by the court, whether the person who has bought the suit has been dispossessed or not, and also he has been dispossessed otherwise than in due course of law or not. Secondly, the limitation period mentioned under section 5, though not mentioned expressly but impliedly, that is 12 years limitation from the date of disposition. It is mentioned in Article 64 and 65 of the Limitation Act, whereas there is a limitation period of 6 months under section 6. 6 months from the date of disposition, the person who has been dispossessed may file the suit. Also, there is some difference between section 145 CRPC and section 6 specific relief act. In section 145 CRPC, it is basically an executive action, that is, it is an order made by the executive magistrate, whereas section 6, it is basically an ordinary civil court action. Another important point, in section 145, there is likelihood of breach of peace. For that, an action under section 145 is to be brought. But there is no such likelihood of breach of peace under section 6 of the Specific Limitation Act. Only what matters is the disposition, whether the person who has bought the suit has been dispossessed otherwise than in due course of law or not. So now let's see what is the object of section 5 and section 6. Firstly, it is to discourage the people from taking the law into their own hands, however good their title may be. Secondly, to provide a summary, cheap and useful remedy to a person dispossessed of the property otherwise than in due course of law. Now finally, let's see an example. Suppose A is in possession of a property of a house. He is being dispossessed by the B otherwise than in due course of law, suppose by use of force. Then A, within 6 months from the date of disposition, will file a suit for recovery of possession. Suppose if the 6 month period lapses, then also A can file under section 5 of the Specific Relief Act read with Article 64 Limitation Act for the recovery of possession on the basis of title, which is being mentioned in section 6 clause 4, and there the limitation period will be 12 months from the date of disposition. So I hope you all will like the video. Please do like and subscribe the video. Thank you everyone.